So, I just want to record this video to give you guys a warning. This was something that went wrong on a product that I launched. So the product went really well. I want to preempt this by saying the product has been a huge success, and it's a product that we are 100% we are reordering because I absolutely love the product. But there was an issue with the first order. So the product is heavy. It has sharp edges, and we needed to spend more time thinking about the packaging, and we didn't do that, and I think that has caused us issues, okay? And it really drives home the need to be very, very careful with your suppliers in terms of like don't always, I don't want to say don't trust them because you can trust them, but it's a like trust but verify, like check to make sure it's okay, right? So the product arrived into Amazon and actually started selling really well. Then we basically noticed that a lot of the stock had become unfillable. Like Amazon said, it wasn't able to be sent out, right? Sometimes this happens, one or two units, right? But this was literally like 200 units. I was like, okay, what is going on here? So what turns out what happened was the product packaging had disintegrated. Okay, not like fell apart, but like literally burst open, right? Because the product was heavy and it was kind of loose in the box slightly, not much, but enough to push through a different parts of it or push the tape up. And ultimately, this meant that all that stock was not sellable. Okay, so we'd organize for that to be returned to ourselves for repackaging because the product itself was fine, just the packaging was gone. Now that cost quite a bit, right? Because we're talking, 200 units, and it is a large product, and it all had to be repackaged, which was very expensive getting packaging in the UK and just time, and it was a huge headache. Now, I'm happy because I know this product is super, super successful. I know it has gone super, super well, and I know it will sell super, super well. But what have I learned from this, and what can you learn from this? Number one, make sure you ask the supplier, is this packaging secure? The master carton was secure. So the master carton had two finished customer cartons in it. It was fine. So it came from China to the UK, no problem. The problem started when the product was removed from the master carton, because then it was in the looser carton and that caused it to move around. And maybe that's why the supplier thought, it'll be fine because it's going to travel in this big safe carton. Yes, it did until it got to Amazon and they opened it up. That's when the problem started, right? And we did get one or two negative reviews, right? Stating that the packaging had fallen apart and they actually lost one or two units in the process of shipping it from Amazon to the customer. But the vast majority of customers were happy, right? Because of the nature of the product. But ultimately, the carton packaging had to be thicker, okay? And what we should have done is we should have specified that directly to the seller that the customer carton packaging had to be thicker. But we assumed that the seller was just making sure that was okay because they're on the ground. Like if I was in China, I would have said like that won't work. But because I was here, sometimes things like this can be missed, right? So that's one thing. Thick packaging, if anything's heavy, right? Any doubt. Also, it is probably worth paying someone in China to go and inspect the goods before they're shipped over to the likes of the UK or to America, especially on your first order when you're still getting to know the supplier. Like I'd never ordered from this supplier before, so this was a first order, right? The supplier themselves were very good and they were very apologetic when this problem came to light, right? But at the same time, if we had someone in China that went to the factory and said, look, guys, this is not right, this could have been preempted, avoided, and ultimately would have saved us a lot of money and a lot of headaches. Because ultimately, we're not selling at the moment. We're repackaging, we're reordering, we're doing all this stuff, which we didn't need to be doing. Now, that aside, we've went back to the supplier and they have proposed a much, much reinforced internal customer carton, right? And they're actually doing it at a reduced cost for us. So I suppose long term, because this product is selling like a lot of units a day, like we're talking, I think it could do 15, 20 units a day. Because of this, we actually have a superior product and we won't have these issues again. I'm fairly confident this will address these issues once and for all. But I think it drives home that, never assume with a Chinese seller. Like, as I said, trust but verify with an inspection agent. That is going to be so important. So make sure the packaging is up to scratch. You do not want to be doing this. And especially for a first order from now on, we're going to get inspection agents just to make sure everything is okay. If there's an issue, they will tell them, they will address it, and the product will be sent out. And then we'll have no issues like this on the first order. But usually once an order goes okay, I'm usually fairly happy to trust the supplier just to make the same thing and send it out and send it out and send it out. That's fairly good. But for the first order, this was a lesson that I've learned and I'm now applying to my business. So hopefully you can do that too. If you're interested in learning more about this, up to my bio, there's ways we can work together. Any questions, put them down in the comments. And thanks for watching.